we understand the genes that are in plants and we compare different plants, we can get plants to do cool things that they've never done before. I'm Mike Deyholos. I'm a professor of biology in the Barber School of Arts and Sciences. One of the things we're working on is we're trying to get flax plants, which are normally grown for their seed, we're trying to use the fiber from their stem to replace fiberglass, and so you can make eventually a completely sustainable and renewable car body, for example. We chose the species that we work on for a number of different reasons. Some of them are orphan crops that are really important only in developing countries and with subsistence farmers, and I think it's important that we try and contribute in our own way to improving those crops as well. And then on the other hand, we focused on what are some major Canadian crops. So flax, for example, Canada's the largest producer in the world of flax, and so it makes sense for us to try and contribute to improvement of that crop as well. In the future, we're going to continue to try and mine all this genomic sequence data. There's an explosion of sequence data that's available. We've been involved in isolating DNA sequence from more than 1,000 different plant species now, and even if we don't eat all 1,000 of those or use all 1,000 of those species, they're really useful for comparisons against each other. And if we understand how plants evolved different strategies for coping with things like potentially climate change, then we can use that information to improve our own crops and make them do useful things as well.